In this video, we're going to be talking about Nano Dimension. This is an update video for Nano and for kind of what the latest and greatest is about Nano. I'm going to be covering their latest acquisition. This is news that happened earlier this week, but I had a crazy week on my channel. Just had a lot of videos I had to create, so just now I'm getting the time to get to this. Really, what I'm going to cover in this is what my opinion is of the big acquisition that Nano did, and what do I think it's going to do as far as an impact on the stock. The stock is currently trading. It ended trading on Friday at $7.34. I'll also give you my opinion of what I think the stock will be from a price prediction standpoint. We'll cover that in this video. If that's something you care about, stick around, please. That's what we're going to be talking about in this one. My name is Austin Hilton. If you're new here, and I cover stocks, I may bring you these update videos. I cover a lot of major companies. I cover companies like Nano that I think are dynamic and exciting, and that have a lot of interest around them. I cover those. I have stock tip videos. I throw in the occasional penny stock video. I also am starting and have done a lot of content now around cryptocurrency. So if that's something that you're interested in or you're trying to figure out, and maybe you're looking at some of the specific coins and tokens like Dogecoin and Bitcoin and Ethereum and some of those other guys, stick around and maybe check out some of my content there. It'll give you a kind of a clarification and an update of kind of what those things are, keep you updated on the price so you can maybe, if you're thinking about crypto, maybe that's a way you kind of ease your toe into the water, so to speak, and kind of start off slow and if that's something you care about. Okay, this video is for entertainment purposes only. I don't know if I've already said that, as always. And I'm a 30 plus year investor, and all I really want to do is help you. I'm building a community here on YouTube to help us all make more money in the stock market, to make more money tomorrow than we have today. That is my goal. It's just to ultimately help you by keeping you updated and giving you my opinion here and there. Okay, so if that's of interest to you, again, please consider subscribing. Drop a like on this video. Dropping a like actually really helps the video and helps the channel and helps me to help more people. So I'd love to help you and help more people. All right, let's do it. Let's go take a look at what I got for you for Nano. So we're going to look at the stock chart, and then we're going to look at some information, a piece of news that I've got for you around Nano. Here we go. So as I mentioned, we closed on Friday at $7.34. So we closed down 4.8%, but it looked like it jumped up a little bit in after hours trading. There's not been a lot of major news, well, outside of what I'm going to talk about, which is the acquisition here in a minute. So really, the stock is, let's look at a 5-day. You can see we've kind of got a downward trend cycle as far as the last 5 days go. A 1-month cycle. Again, we've kind of hit our bottom in the last month of 664 on April 19th. Yep. Okay. And if you look at a 6-month chart, which is really, I think, where a lot of the telling the information is that you can see we're really kind of in a sideward pattern. We're just moving sidewards. Sideways, not sideways. Moving sideways. We're in a sideways pattern, okay? And our bottom support level really seems to be, again, probably no less than about 650, give or take. And so I think that really is our bottom support level. The stock has really held up nicely to some overall not great market conditions. I mean, you know, you've got a scenario here from February 9th. To March 5th, you had a 54% drop there. The stock almost immediately rebounded back up to, another 50%, you know, bounce back up. And then from there, we've just kind of had this slow kind of meandering sideways pattern where we're just kind of drifting down just a little bit. And so as far as predictions go, I think that what Nano does, they've continued to execute. They've done two major acquisitions now. This last one I think is more major than the first one, but they've done two acquisitions. Let's call them that, right? I think that they're building out their technology, their overall market, you know, their overall portfolio of products and tech and things like that. We know that they've got a pretty good war chest of money, of cash. So I think that I'm not worried about their stability from a cash flow standpoint. I'm not really worried about that. They're using the cash like they said they would to go out and do, you know, acquisitions of other tech and companies that will come in and augment and add to what they do and ultimately help their customers. I think they just got to continue to execute. We got to get some positive catalysts moving forward. I think that this could be a $14 stock inside of 12 months to 18 months. I think it absolutely could double. Things have got to go the right way for us in that scenario. But, you know, overall, if you're kind of looking at it from a long-term hold standpoint, I think that, you know, at this price point, it's not a bad if it fits your portfolio, it fits your investment style, what you're trying to do, I think it's not a bad investment overall. You got to go into it eyes wide open, and you kind of got to know, hey, this is going to be, it's going to have a little bit of volatility about it, and you're going to have times kind of like where we're at now where the stock's not doing a lot, and you kind of got to look at it and go, all right, I'm willing to kind of ride it out because I believe, you know, in this company. There is a pretty loyal fan base to the company overall, people that really, really like it. Every time I release a Nano Dimension video on my channel, it does really, really well, which is telling me that there's a lot of interest, and there is a pretty strong following and loyal base. I think they will continue to stand behind the stock and continue to kind of propel it moving forward. Okay, so those are just my thoughts, as well as kind of giving you some peek behind the curtain and letting you know that that's what I'm seeing as a content creator when I release a Nano Dimension video. Okay, so let's take a look at this piece of content I have for you. So basically, Deep Learning Business Acquisition, that was the company that they bought. This deep learning business makes it's helping to make Nano a stronger buy. Okay, so NNDM is now more compelling as Nano Dimension makes its 3D printers even smarter. Again, I think this was a really good strategic acquisition, and I think that it's going to help move the stock forward. It really didn't do anything to the stock last week. I was kind of hoping that it would be a catalyst, which frankly, cards on the table, is why I didn't release a video on Nano. I wanted to see what the stock would do last week after the acquisition, was made public. Didn't really do anything. So I was like, well, okay. And I was hoping that it would move higher. Okay. And it just really didn't. But the stock, I think right now at the current levels, is primed for a buy if you are thinking about, and again, holding long term, and if you believe in where this company is going and the overall market conditions. I do like Nano Dimension's pursuit of acquisitions. I think that that's one thing that's helping to make them, to help kind of set them apart. I like that Nano is a disruptor. They do it better, kind of faster, cheaper, smaller with their technology. I like that they're a disruptor in their overall market, and I've covered them in 3, 4, 5 videos. So I definitely think that that we've got long-term good prospects. Okay. And I think that this may be true. The stock may not be trading at a reduced price for much, much longer. Okay, so so a closer look at the stock. Stock is traded for less than $1. We've talked about that starting in September of 2020. The short sellers have been badly bruised as the price climbed relentlessly through 2020. I love that. But it did retrace, backwards, right? And so we hit the high of 1789. Yep, we know that. We are now, we're not at $8, we're a little bit less, okay? So, but right now, I think that the $12 to $15, it is very, very doable for this stock, again, inside of a 12-month time frame, if not faster. We know that they're in a growth market. The 3D printer market that they're in is a multi-billion dollar market, and I think that they are continuing to do this acquisition scenario, and I like that they're doing that. They are one of the key players in the 3D printed electronics market. That's only going to continue to get bigger and bigger and bigger. We need, those semiconductors, those pre-3D printed electronics. They just need to continue to do to get more of those. I like that Nano is focused specifically on 3D additive manufacturing, in this 3D printed electronic markets. It's going to continue to grow. It's a growth market, and they're going to be one of the major, major players. It's still a billion plus dollar market. And this compound annual growth rate of 24% is quite impressive from an overall marketing standpoint. We know that Cathie Wood has made the investment in Nano, and to my knowledge, she hasn't sold any. I don't follow every move that she makes, but I don't think that she's sold anything. And look, it's the 19th largest holding. And I'm gonna say this, I've said this before, they're smart people, and frankly, they're a heck of a lot smarter than me. And sometimes you gotta put the ego aside and go, hey, what are the smarter people in the room doing? And I love that they are in this stock, and they continue to be in this stock. And again, from what I know, have held the stock and holding the stock long term, continuing to just be a major holder of it, and really believer in the stock. That's really what it comes down to. You know, if I think if they I think if they saw if there was some issues, they would have already been kind of exiting stage left. And we haven't seen that, right? So I think that that's really, really a good scenario. You know, we know that they bought DeepCube. That was an earlier acquisition, but with this acquisition, what they're doing is I think it's continuing. It's really this acquisition is really going to the heart of helping to augment and make their technology better and just to overall you know, move the company forward. I think we're going to continue potentially to see some sideways movement until we get a little bit further into the year. We get some maybe more catalysts behind us. We get some positive earnings calls and things like that. So that's my two cents on this. I wanted to update you guys. Again, I wanted to wait just a little bit to see kind of what had happened with the with what the stock would do after this announcement. Didn't get a lot of movement. I was hoping we'd get some more movement, but I think again, if it's this is a buy and hold scenario, if you're in it for the long term, I think you're good. And I think it's a $12 to $15 stock inside of a year. I think that we got Kathy and Ark behind us. I think we're looking good. So that's my two cents. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please consider subscribing if you haven't already done so. Drop a like on the video if you got any value out of it. I greatly appreciate it. I'll see you down the road. As I always say, go make some money. Take care. See ya. Bye.